104.5 XLO, New England's best variety. We are Jen and Frank. It is Wednesday. We are live in the Clinton Savings Bank studio with Worcester City Manager Ed Augustus. Hi, Ed. How are you?
I'm good, Frank. How are you? Hi, Jen.
You stalled there a little, yeah. Ed.
Did you have to think about it?
I had to double check.
Okay. Did everything check out all right?
Well, the weather's beautiful.
Good.
You got to love that.
Exactly. I'm enjoying the weather. The weather's really picking me up. So.
Oh, so nice.
Speaking of the weather, it allowed the restaurants in Boston along Newbury Street to open up a little bit early with outside dining. How are we looking in Worcester for our comeback for outside dining?
Well, the authorization that we gave last year is still in effect until May 1st. So any restaurant that wants to open up that has the outside extension of premises license from last year can do so right up until May 1st. And then we're going to extend it beyond that and possibly look to make it permanent, because I think it's something that was very well received. It helps the restaurants. People like it. It makes it safer. It also makes just the city more lively having outside dining.
Now, Ed, the weather's getting nice. People are thinking about baseball and going out to the ballpark. Some new parking options that are going to be available in the city. Talk a little bit about these new multi-space parking meters.
Yeah, it's really just getting Worcester into the 21st century when it comes to parking. We still have nickel parking meters.
I know.
and it just doesn't really make sense. Not a lot of people walking around with a pocket full of nickels to feed the meter.
So I saw a lot of butt crack, Ed, from people bent over trying to get that nickel out from underneath their seat.
Yeah, you can never get that out of your head.
No.
You're always looking for change, though, Ed. It's so true. Whenever you want to park.
Yeah, so we need to really meet people where they are. People usually have their debit cards or their credit cards with them. And it allows them to do a lot of this through a phone app so that you can, if your appointment's going longer than your meter, you could reload it from your phone. It allows you to find an open parking place, gives you kind of a warning when your time is about to run out if you need to reload. So it really has a lot of conveniences for the customer.
One of the questions I get asked all the time, people tell me, boy, that's a beautiful park. Is there going to be any place to park? And my reaction is, no, jackass. They built the whole thing and there's not going to be anywhere to park. But I'll get the official word from you, Ed. Is there going to be any parking over at the ballpark?
Yeah, jackass, there's going to be parking over there.
Well, we didn't think about that.
We're really spoiled in a lot of ways. We kind of have this expectation that we're going to pull in front, we're going to pay nothing for parking,
God.
And we're going to stay as long as we want. And if you go to any city, like, you don't necessarily expect to pull in front. You expect to walk a few blocks. Now, the obligation of the city is try to make sure that walk is safe, is clean, is interesting, and that's really all that we've been doing in terms of public art and, you know, the BID district, the business improvement district. We have ambassadors on the streets that, you know, clean up and sweep, and there will be flower planters on the streetlights and other things just to make those experiences much more kind of interesting and attractive.
Thanks, Ed. As always, we'll talk to you next week.
Sounds good, guys. Take care.
Bye.
Bye.